A very good morning, friends. Today we will discuss about an important topic in biochemistry, that is ketone bodies, synthesis and utilization. There are three main ketone bodies, that is acetone, acetoacetate and beta hydroxy butyrate. Of these two, first two, they are known as true ketone bodies because they contain keto group. For example, acetone, it contains keto group. Then acetoacetate, and beta hydroxy butyrate, it contains OH, beta hydroxy butyrate. These two, that is acetone and beta hydroxy butyrate, they are synthesized from the acetoacetate. That's why this acetoacetate is known as primary ketone body, while these two, they are known as secondary ketone bodies. The ketone bodies, they are detected in urine by the test that is known as Rothera's test. Only acetone and acetoacetate, they are detected by the Rothera's test. While beta hydroxy butyrate, it is not detected by the general Rothera's test, it is detected by the modified Rothera's test. And one special test is for acetoacetate, that is known as Gerhard's test. Gerhard's ferric chloride test, which is given by the acetoacetate. Normal concentration of ketone body in blood, it is less than 1 milligram per deciliter. Now coming to the synthesis of ketone bodies. The synthesis specially occurs in the liver, in the mitochondria of the liver. So site for the synthesis is mitochondria of liver. Then it is synthesized mainly when there is mainly in two conditions. The first one is the clinical conditions which are related to the ketone body synthesis. The first one is the uncontrolled diabetes mellitus, and second one is the starvation. There is decreased uptake of glucose by the cells due to the deficiency of insulin in uncontrolled diabetes mellitus. As there is decrease in the glucose concentration in the inside the cell, there is accelerated lipolysis, which generates fatty acids, and this utilization of fatty acid gives the acetyl coenzyme A. And as there is large amount of acetyl CoA synthesized, and deficiency of oxaloacetate lead to the diversion of this acetyl coenzyme A for the ketone body synthesis in the uncontrolled diabetes mellitus. While in starvation, there is decreased glucose. This oxaloacetate, it is diverted for the synthesis of glucose. So there is deficiency of oxaloacetate, and fatty acids, they are used as an energy source. So there is increased production of acetyl coenzyme A. So that lead to the diversion of this acetyl coenzyme A for ketone body synthesis. So these are the two important conditions in which ketone body synthesis occurs. And some tissue, they prefer the utilization of ketone bodies over the glucose, that is the heart muscles and second one is the renal cortex. They prefer ketone body as a fuel source over a glucose. Now coming to the synthesis proper, steps in the ketone body synthesis. The two molecule of acetyl coenzyme A condenses with the help of thiolase. So acetyl coenzyme A plus acetyl coenzyme A, they will give acetoacetyl coenzyme A. The enzyme here is thiolase. It again condenses with another molecule of acetyl coenzyme A and gives hydroxymethyl glutaryl coenzyme A with the help of enzyme HMG-CoA synthase, and this is a regulatory step in the ketone body synthase. HMG-CoA synthase. Now HMG-CoA lyase forges the cleavage of this HMG-CoA into acetoacetate and acetyl coenzyme A. This acetoacetate generated here, this is the primary ketone body, which on spontaneous decarboxylation, that is non-enzymatic decarboxylation, it will give acetone, and this is with the help of NADH dependent beta hydroxy butyrate dehydrogenase, that is beta hydroxy butyrate dehydrogenase, it will give beta hydroxy butyrate. So these are known as secondary ketone bodies, acetone and beta hydroxy butyrate. This is the primary ketone body. The regulatory enzyme in this step is HMG-CoA synthase. So this is ketogenesis, specially increases in the condition known as uncontrolled diabetes mellitus and starvation. Now coming to the utilization of ketone bodies, it is specially utilized by the extrahepatic tissue, means utilization of ketone body occurs in the extrahepatic tissue. It is not utilized by the liver and RBCs. So it is utilized by extrahepatic tissues. So in this, of these three, acetoacetate, acetone and beta hydroxybutyrate, this acetone, it is a volatile substance. It is not metabolized in the body and it gets exhaled through the lung. While there is metabolism of beta hydroxybutyrate and acetoacetate. So in the utilization, this beta hydroxybutyrate with the help of beta hydroxybutyrate dehydrogenase, it gets converted into acetoacetate, which condenses with succinyl coenzyme A and it will give acetoacetyl coenzyme A. This is with the help of thiophorase, which is absent in the liver, hence it is not metabolized by the liver. This thiophorase, it is absent in the liver. So this acetoacetyl coenzyme A again condenses with the coenzyme ASH and it will give two molecules of acetyl coenzyme A. So this utilization of ketone body, it will give energy, as there is production of NADH here. So utilization of beta hydroxybutyrate, it will give two molecules of acetyl coenzyme A, means the 20 ATP plus 1 NADH, which will give 2.5 ATP. So the net the total generation of ATP will be 22.5 and 1 is utilized, so there is minus 1, so it will give 21.5 ATP. So net ATP generation by the ketone body utilization is 21.5 ATP when it is by the beta hydroxy butyrate. When by the acetoacetate, it will give net 19 ATP. So this is the degradation or utilization of ketone bodies. The normal concentration in blood, it is less than 1 milligram per deciliter. If the concentration increases above the 1 milligram per deciliter, the condition is known as ketonemia. So if it is, if there is increased ketone bodies in the blood, it is known as ketonemia. And its excretion in urine, it is known as ketoneuria. And together, this condition, ketonemia and ketoneuria, which is specially occurs in the uncontrolled diabetes mellitus or diabetic ketoacidosis and starvation, it lead to the ketosis. And excretion of acetone, which is exhaled through the lung in the breath, that gives the characteristic fruity odor to the breath in a patient with diabetic ketoacidosis. This ketosis is because of generation of ketone bodies, that is acetoacetate and beta hydroxy butyrate, which leads to the acidotic breathing in the diabetic ketoacidosis patient, that is known as Kussmaul respiration due to the hyperventilation. So this is all about the ketone body synthesis and their utilization. So it is synthesizes in the liver, especially the mitochondria of liver, and utilizes by the extrahepatic tissue. So this is all about the ketone body synthesis and degradation. Keep watching. Thank you.